morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for attending the Veterans Day ceremony. My name is Paul Williams, Jr. I am the commander of VFW Post 1343 here in Rochester, and I'm so happy that all of you came out today. Today is Veterans Day. It's a special day. It's where we honor our veterans that are living, and it is important that we do that. Some places have drifted away from it, and I'm so glad to see that Rochester has not. At this time, the VFW chaplain is going to come up and give the invocation.
Okay, we could all bow your heads here. Almighty God, Father of us all, we, your servants, turn to you for a continuance of your blessings upon us. You who have spared us veterans from the grasp of our enemies, grant us the full understanding of your precious comfort. We thank you for the privilege of life and the blessings we enjoy through your graciousness in our country, the land in which we are given the freedom of speech, religion, and the pursuit of happiness. Assist us to know you better and the wisdom to acknowledge you as the God of the universe in our ideal. Okay. In your mercy, may we the living find our peace. Grant us from above this day the challenge of high endeavor, the beauty of a humble spirit, the strong courage and will without exertion to continue to glorify you, to praise you, and to love you to the end of time. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain. At this time, the Boy Scouts and the Cub Scouts, I'd ask them to come up, and they're going to lead us in this reciting the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts. Can we get a round of applause for them real quick? They're out here braving this cold, and some of them didn't even want to put their sweaters on. They wanted to wear their shirts proudly, and that's admirable of them. Highly admirable. Thank you. Yes. All right, at this time, I would ask Mayor Denton to come up, please, and he will do the welcome for the opening of the ceremony.
Thank you.
Thank you much.
You betcha. Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Thank you all for being here today. I just have a couple of remarks, and then I'll get out of the way because it is a little chilly, but it's a great day to honor our veterans. You know, last week I had an opportunity to speak to some second graders, and they were talking about the election and everything that was going on, and the term about some of the people running were that they were veteran politicians. And one little fella said to me, he said, "What is a veteran?" And I thought, wow, made me think. A veteran is a lot of things, but of course today, you know, we look at veterans as the 20 million folks in the United States who have served in the military. Of course, combat veterans are those who have seen combat, but I believe that that definition, veteran, goes farther than that. I believe anyone who is a veteran in the United States of America is a pure American. The best of the best. And I've noted a few things about vets that I have noted over the years. You will never see a veteran take a knee when the national anthem is played. You will never see a veteran not at attention. You will never see a veteran not at attention with hand over heart when the Pledge of Allegiance is recited. You will never see a veteran at any age, male or female, stand by and watch while the flag is desecrated. You will never see a veteran yelling obscenities in a group as the commander-in-chief passes by. You will never see a veteran seated when the flag is passing in a parade. And you will never see a veteran sit idle when his God, his country, his Constitution, or his fellow citizens are threatened by any form of tyranny. Any aged veteran I have ever talked with told me the same thing. If they were ever called again to serve their country, they would go in a heartbeat. These are pure Americans, ladies and gentlemen. They have left their mark on the world, and they are the reason we can meet here today without any fear of intervention. Thank you for your service, all you veterans, and five words that we should never forget when we see a veteran is thank you for your service. But don't say that only on Veterans Day. Say that anytime you see a veteran. God bless our veterans and God bless America.
Mayor Denton, thank you for those words. All right, at this time, the Rochester High School Band is going to play a service medley for us to honor all the services. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor at this time to bring up our keynote speaker. His name is Mr. Rick Fouts, and he is our Fulton County Veteran Service Officer. Mr. Fouts is a United States Army veteran, and he served in Vietnam. So not only did he get done with his service, he wanted to serve again. And he's now ensuring that we get the help that we need with our VA claims. He gets veterans to their appointments and a myriad of other things that are done behind the scenes that not everybody sees. So at this time, Mr. Rick Fouts.
Good morning, everyone. I'm glad you turned out in such a chilly day. I appreciate it very much. It's an honor for me to speak here. It's great. I'm very appreciative of the opportunity. First off, I don't get to speak much, so I wanted to point out some recognition, and I'm here at the down here in the basement. I'm the paper pusher, and the guys that really do all the hard labor, I feel like, are my DAV drivers, and I cannot operate this department without them. And I want hats off to number one, Rick Baber. He is a just an absolute right-hand man. He's the guy that's out there with that personal touch, with meeting the veterans, getting them to Marion, Fort Wayne, Indianapolis, where they need to go. And right behind his heels is Kurt Ponto. Right now, Kurt is not here. He's out delivering food. The vets helping vets. They last weekend, they went and accumulated a boatload of food, and we're able to take boxes out to 23 veterans that's needy for the holidays. That includes not only meat and staples, so hats off to them. I want to give you a real quick lowdown. Ray Boardman came into my office last year on these vets, helping vets. And this fellow, I looked up, and he's rather intimidating. Sickle gang, and he looked every part of it. But I'm telling you what, don't judge a book by his cover. That fellow has a heart of gold, and that whole gang worked their tails off getting this food for these vets. Third, I want to thank Dwayne Balon. He's my summer guy. Basically, he's in school. He helps out when in the summer. And the fourth is Bill Miller. He's under the weather, and I hope he gets better, but he's always there when Rick or Kurt can't be there. I also want to thank Bernie Holloway, a former VSO here, and I tell you what, he's been real helpful to me, get my feet on the ground. It's always nice to be able to call somebody and, hey, what's the insight on this? And he's been very helpful. And one other person, Jay Kendall down at Miami County. He is the VSO 17 years, and quite frankly, I think he's, my personal opinion, he's the best in the state. His numbers show it. And he's always there for me to help, or for him to help me. And he wrote an article, and I gave it to Wes Denny to put in the Rochester Sentinel. And it talks about a town hall meeting, and I put this on your calendar, December 8th at 5 p.m. at the VFW in Peru. There'll be all kinds of VA officials from Indianapolis and the VA healthcare in Northern District. So they're there to help you with questions and interest. And also your support down there will help that Peru CBOC. Maybe we get some more growth and doctors down there. We don't have to drive so far. We're gathered here today, the 11th month, 11th day, and the 11th hour to celebrate Armistice Day. That was in 1918, the war that ended all wars, World War I. Well, as we all know, that unfortunately that did not happen. So in 1951, June 1, they changed the name from Armistice Day to Veterans Day. And, excuse me.
That's all right.
Since on that day, we have been honoring veterans who have served and the soldiers defending our way of life all over the globe. We come together and recognize and honor the veterans and active military for the sacrifice that they have and are currently encountering. Only those military personnel that have answered the call of duty have any idea what it's like to be away from loved ones, experience the fear, witness the horrible atrocities of war, also experience the loyalty and the bond of a military that military unit possesses, the self-sacrifice of the one or the few for the good of the many. I saw a quote in the National Guard, National American Legion 2009, I'd like to quote, fewer than 10% of Americans can claim the title of a military veteran. And what a list of accomplishments that those 10% can claim. Defeating communism, fascism, and imperialism, to keeping the peace during the Cold War and battling terrorism today. America owes a debt to her veterans that can never be repaid. Winston Churchill stated, "Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few." Today is important because we choose to honor the living veterans from the greatest generation to the latest generation. But we must honor them with deeds, not just words. We must heed the words of the first commander-in-chief, General George Washington, who said, "The willingness with which our young people will fight in any war, no matter how justified, shall be directly proportional as to how they perceive the veterans of earlier wars and treated and appreciated by their country." Born of extraordinary accomplishments comes extraordinary debt. Part of that debt is owed to military families that have sacrificed so much for their country. We must honor these families, and not just with the blue and gold star banners, but with compassionate hearts. The PTSD, traumatic brain injury, and the life-altering war wounds not only affect the veteran, but they can also take an enormous toll on the family as well. Unquote. I have come to know a lot of veterans here in Fulton County, and I can tell you some of the amazing things that they had to endure. From being captured in Germany, held prisoner, and the hardships of being a prisoner, the horrible scenes witnessed in the Battle of the Bulge, to the IEDs in Iraq and Afghanistan, blowing up their convoy vehicles, and disabling their soldiers, wounding them for life or killing. Not to mention the people in Korea and Vietnam, the horrendous massive attacks by the enemy, the horrible conditions, and the effects of chemical warfare. These veterans now bear the scars today, psychologically and physically. Too many of our veterans are not receiving the benefits that they deserve. I think for one, we have a proud and strong-willed group of veterans. They feel that they're better off than some, and those benefits should go to the other person that's not as well off. I commend these veterans for their not having a welfare mentality. However, if we don't demand that funding, the money will go to some other political lobbyist. Number two, veterans are being denied benefits and receiving improper care that they deserve from our national government and Veterans Administration. The political game makes the system inefficient, and many veterans just don't want to go through the hassle. Third, and I think the most important reason, veterans need to understand this: your benefits are not an entitlement, it's an earned benefit. These benefits not only help you, they help the community. Every dollar of earned benefits gets spent somewhere. If it's spent in the community, local business profits, the state sales tax profit, and standard living increases, property assessments increase, and so on. The circle of wealth continues to rise. I want to close with an invitation for you folks to come in and see me. I'm here at the courthouse Monday through Friday, 8 to 2. I can guarantee you, if you don't try, you will not receive anything. And it, like I said, it not only hurts you, it hurts the community as well. Thank a vet today and every day. for their service that gives us freedom that we enjoy today. We are so fortunate to live in a country that where we have the opportunity to achieve anything, our dreams, our ambitions, our abilities can take us. May God bless you, and may God bless America. I need Shauna Bueller. Is Shauna Bueller here? Shauna? Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Fouts, for those kind words. Well spoken. At this time, I would like to ask, if you're a Vietnam veteran, if you would please raise your hand. Ladies and gentlemen, the Vietnam veterans were some of the most mistreated and not cared for veterans in this country's great history. I just recently retired out of the Army, and one of the greatest things I've ever seen done before I retired was Fort Riley, Kansas, put on a welcome home ceremony for the Vietnam veterans. And that touched not only those veterans, but it touched our soldiers, our young soldiers. And it made a lasting impact on them. So on behalf of the American Legion, Rochester Post, and the VFW Rochester, I say to all of you Vietnam veterans, welcome home, and thank you for your service and your sacrifice. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please give them a round of applause. Now, we are a little ahead of schedule, so some of you may not know me. I'm new to the Rochester area, and I'm also a young post commander. So what I'd like to speak for 1 second is, if you're a young veteran out there and you're not sure about your veteran service organizations, because they don't do a good job about telling us what we need and the help we need when we get out, see Mr. Fouts, come to the VFW, come to the American Legion, join those organizations. If we don't have those organizations, we lose voices in Washington. And if we lose voices in D.C., that narrows the pool of who advocates for us. And as you can see by the people standing here that are not just veterans, we have quite a bit of support here in Rochester. And I can't thank the people of Rochester, those of you that are not veterans, enough for coming out to support us on Veterans Day. It means a lot to me. It means a lot to every veteran standing here, all the ones behind me, the Honor Guard. We can't thank you enough for the support that you give us. Whether it's coming to eat in the VFW, attending events put on by the Legion, all of it. It means a lot to us. So I, on behalf of all of them, I'd like to thank you for that. Thank you very much. Some of you may ask why I'm talking a little bit. Mr. Fouts alluded to something. The 11th hour of the 11th month of the 11th day. That is traditionally when we fire our volley. And it's closing in on that 11th hour. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to turn it back over to the Rochester High School Band. And I would ask that everybody please rise and remove your headgear as they play the national anthem. Outstanding Rochester High School band, outstanding. Thank you once again for supporting us. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to put out, especially to the veterans, that from 4 to 6 today, excuse me, let me back up that order. Immediately following this ceremony, the American Legion is going to be having chili. And right now, I would like to ask their commander to come up here real quick and give the full details on that. And remember, the Legion building is right down here off of Main Street.
Yes, we're going to have chili for all your veterans and probably ham sandwiches for anybody that wants to come. I'm glad you're all out here today, and thank you very much. And I'll turn it back over to Paul.
Thank you, Sonny. Appreciate that. Also, from 4 to 6 p.m., we will have a free veterans dinner at the VFW. In addition to the normal menu that is served at 5 o'clock, we are going to also serve some ribs and some pork loin. So I encourage all of you to come out. It is 100% free to the veterans and their families. By all means, please join us. All of you are welcome. At this time, I want to ask Mr. Fouts to come back up. We're going to present an honor quilt, and he's going to lead us through that.
Well, I'm going to invite Shada Bueller to come up because her and a group of ladies have created a very honorable tribute to our veterans. I'll let, here is Shada Bueller.
Thank you. It is with honor that I can present a quilt of valor. My sorority, Kappa 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 Beta Mu, sponsored this quilt. I had contacted Rick and asked him how to select a veteran, because all of you are deserving. My mother, Angela McDonald, actually quilted it, and I will try to get through this without crying. I'm not going to guarantee it. So when Rick and I spoke, we said, how do we select? We chose World War II veterans. And amazingly, we have, we believe, 40 veterans, is that right, Rick? That are still surviving from World War II in Fulton County. That is awesome. That is terrific. So it is with honor that I present this quilt, and I'm going to try not to lose the, it's a little windy. We actually put all the veterans together and we drew a name because we weren't sure how to do this with fairness, and that was the best way we felt we could do it. So we were able to draw Emerson Enyart was the veteran that we drew. So if Emerson is here or his family, I'm not sure that, he's working, you're right. And they're, with this wind, we're gonna try to display the quilt.
It's gonna look like a sailor, you guys.
Yeah. This is definitely an honor for my mother to do, and she wants to continue this, and we want to try to continue the tradition of honoring our veterans
down the bottom corner
with a quilt. Got it? So there you go. Thank you, veterans, for all of your service.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Boy Scouts, for helping display that quilt. At this time, I'm going to ask Mr. Ben Parsons from Representative Jackie Leworski's office to come up, and he's going to speak very quickly. He has some words from her, and we will let him speak. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here today. Congresswoman couldn't be here herself, so I'm going to read just a short greeting on her behalf. She writes, "Dear friends and fellow Americans, I wish I could be there with you today to honor our veterans, but I join you in gratitude for their service and sacrifice. On Veterans Day, our nation reflects on the debt that we owe to all of our brave men and women who have served in uniform to keep our nation safe and free. Today we pay special tribute to all the veterans right here in Rochester. As the daughter of an Air Force veteran, I know the dedication and devotion and devoted service our military men and women provide. And as a member of the House Armed Services and Veterans Affairs Committee, I know how important it is to fight for our service members and veterans.
So to all of our veterans, I say thank you for your service. Thank you for answering the call when your country needed you, and for risking everything so America could remain free. Thank you for protecting us from those who would harm us. Your nation and your community will never forget your selflessness and your patriotism. As we honor our veterans, let us also think of the men and women serving today, especially those serving far from their families. We pray for their safety and for their success and the success of their missions. And we pray for the strength of their families here at home. May God bless you, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Parsons. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we will have the salute from the Fulton County Honor Guard. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. I would like to thank each and every one of you for attending. Thank you, veterans, for attending to be honored. Thank you, Rochester High School Band, for your medley, the performance of Taps and the National Anthem, the Boy Scouts for the Pledge of Allegiance, the Fulton County Honor Guard for your salute to the service, the American Legion, thank you for your assistance, and my fellow VFW members. Thank you all for attending. God bless Rochester, God bless Indiana, and God bless America. Thank you.